Find your shoes. Hopefully you know where you put them. Take off your cap and goggles. Somebody always forgets. Make your way up the hill.
This is a new passion, open water swimming.
Yeah. It sure didn't feel like it, a new passion. This is Austin, Texas in April. This is quintessentially what Austin does. This is the Splash and Dash. It starts every third Tuesday of the month. And just a huge triathlon base here in Austin, and it's, for me, leaving swimming and kind of coming into this was a perfect fit for me. I love the competition end of it, but my favorite is the positive atmosphere that this brings. So, but it is fun, and you better believe if I'm going to be in it, I'm going to be going pretty hard and competitive. So I've been training good, and I'll do about 5 or 6 races till September, and then we'll see what we'll do from there.
So I think people would be surprised why you didn't do breaststroke in that.
Well, as you can see, I'm wearing a wetsuit. This is the BlueSeventy Helix. It's new for 2009 or 2010. If you've ever swam in your life without a wetsuit on and then put a wetsuit on, it's a pretty substantial difference. The material in your legs are quite thick, probably about 1/4 inch. And then in my arms here, you can see the little grip pad right there. It's real thin. So as far as range of motion, I never would have worn a suit with sleeves and legs when I was swimming. But for an open water swim like this, it feels really comfortable. And in Texas, you can float the Guadalupe River with an inner tube, but I think I'm just going to wear my wetsuit and float down the river because you float pretty good in these things. And it makes it a little more fun. I don't know how fair it is, but it's fun. So that's about it.
Well, if everybody has one, it's a level playing field.
Yeah. Well, if you watch today a little bit, there was people out there with all kinds of wetsuits. A lot of times, this water right now is 63 degrees, so you'd want to wear a wetsuit. But your Ironmans and your half Ironmans and stuff like that, you'll see a lot of triathletes wearing a wetsuit. But other than that, just a regular kind of a jammer-esque top suit to work will be just as sufficient for these sprint races and stuff. But I'm telling you, man, triathlons, even though I'm, a well-rounded swimmer, these runners, they come after me, man, and it makes it fun. And I think the biggest difference for me between triathlons and swimming is I can literally hear my opponent. I know I can talk to them. I can hear them. I can hear their breathing. I know when they're breaking them and stuff like that, which in swimming, you never had that opportunity. Your head was in the water, and you didn't know what your opponents were feeling or body language or anything like that. If you see a runner and you're catching him and he starts driving his head, then you know you got him and you can keep going. But never had that in swimming. So that makes it a lot more fun and has definitely kept me competitive and in shape. And that's not round. I'm about, I'm actually about 9 pounds or 10 pounds lighter than I was when I was competitively swimming. So I think that's partial to the running. Which, if you want to see a breaststroker out of water running, that's this guy. It's pretty awful.
So how come you're not running today the rest of the race?
I've been running a lot, training a lot, and I strained my calf muscle. So I'm kind of recovering from that. I have a 10K on Saturday, road race, just all running, which I'm really excited about, and I want to do well in that. So I decided to just splash today and no dash. They're dashing still as we speak. My heart rate's still about 130, so.
And your coach lets you get away with skipping practices now?
Yeah, coach, exactly. Now, I swim and train and compete with a triathlon group here in town called T3. And an old swimmer at Texas is now the coach out there, so I know him real well and stuff. So he told me to come out here and do this today. So Eddie Reese has no say in this at all now. He does come by me every time I see him on the pool deck or something and grab my arm and say, "What are you weighing these days?" About 145. So He tries to put in those quirky jokes still, but he doesn't have a say in how I'm doing.
Will he?
Good. Yeah, who knows, man? I don't know. Now that we went back to jammers, it makes me want to kind of come back a little bit more than these other suits. If the suits that were worn, the J-Kids and the arenas, if they were anything like this BlueSeventy, it'd be hard for me to believe that I couldn't have gone pretty fast in them, because this suit's amazing. I've never wore the really fast suits. I always wore the fastest suit I ever wore was a jammer. So, oh no, the laser pants is what I wore in the Olympics. Hey, this is Brendan Hansen on GoSwim.tv, and I'll tell you what, if you're plateauing and swimming, triathlon world might be where you want to go, because if you look behind me, this is a whole different animal and a lot of fun, so check it out.